Hey, what's up guys? I'm Mercy with discountlowvoltage.com. Now, if you purchase some pre-terminated fiber optic cable assemblies, you might have thought, what am I going to do with that slack? What do I do with that? Well, let's check out a couple options for you, and depending on what type of cable you purchased, one option will probably be better for you than the other. So, let's get to it. Now, a lot of times if you have a little bit extra, you may want to consider inside the rack mount trays. There is an option, for example, this Corning part number here, the reference number 69187. If you scroll down on the page, there's a video there that you can play. And on the video, they do have cable management tabs. Let me go ahead and forward so you can get a better look at it there. And there's a good look at it right there. So basically your cable would come in, your excess slack, you'd go ahead and coil it in there, keep it all nice and neat, plug it to your adapter panel plates on the front of the enclosure, and that's one option for you right there. Let's see if I got a better shot here for you. There we go. There's a good look at them. So you go ahead and coil it up in there, keep everything nice and neat. Now, the other thing you might want to consider, there's also a PDF spec sheet below that video that'll. It helps you install, get installation aid that show you how exactly you're supposed to install that cable so you'd get a better feel for that slack and how to put it in there proper. You may also want to consider looking at the wall mount slack storage enclosure and reference number 69259. They're fairly inexpensive, and let's see. Here's a good look at it. You can tell it has the little rubber grommets where the cable would come in on the top, bottom, the size, depending on where your cable's coming in. You can go ahead. Lots of options there for you. And it does have the cable management storage loop there, so you can coil it up, keep it all nice and neat. The other thing you might want to look at is, you know, those two options are great for indoor-outdoor cable construction, maybe just an indoor rated, really small diameter, flexible. Be really nice to, it's nice to work with. That's probably better for that type of cable. Now, if you're working with an outdoor cable, for example, maybe, let's say an ADSS fiber, the self-supporting stuff, you may want to look at the, what's commonly called snowshoes. Now, this is reference number 68203 on the website, and they're sold per pair. And on the bottom of the page, there is a video, so you can get a better feel for it. But below that, there is a spec sheet PDF. And when you open that, when you scroll down, there is a diagram of the typical installation. So you'd go ahead and pull some more on one side of the pole, run it back to the other side, bring it back, take it back that way. And then that way you have it all organized out in the field, up on between pole to pole. So that's how you do maybe that application. If you have an ADSS cable, that is something you may want to consider. Now, for the direct burial cable, that stuff's not very flexible when you braid inside, so putting something like that inside one of those fiber trays is not going to be easy, and probably something you shouldn't do. You may want to consider, you should have hand holes installed on those long direct burial applications, and that's where you'd hide your slack. Now, there's a good example of it right there. Looks like it's zip tied nice and neat underground in the handhole. And here's another shot, another example right there of what it looks like. So that excess direct burial slack, you'd want to put some of it in there. Once you bring that cable into the building, you're not supposed to bring it into the building more than 50 feet per National Electric Code, and it's not a very flexible cable, so you're not going to want to have a lot of that inside to be coiled up. And the last thing I want to mention is, I'll put a link on this page. There is, from Cable Installation and Maintenance Magazine, there's a nice little read here on planning for slack and the telecommunications closet. So if you're running fiber, I'm assuming you probably already have copper in there, and maybe it's a good idea to go ahead and reorganize everything from scratch, maybe redo everything, keep it all nice and neat for the long term down the road. And there is an example, they do have procedures here on how to do that, and there's also a little diagram there basically talking about how you're supposed to mount some cable ladder tray on the wall and then bring it down when it comes in, do a U-shape, bring it back out, coil it, you know, run it back to the ladder and then bring it out to the rack to the enclosure. So I'll put this link in there. It's a nice little read, so you can go ahead and check it out and get a better feel for what, you know, maybe what you're supposed to do with your slack the right way. Okay, so one other thing I almost forgot to mention was inside the building or the closet, in the closet next to the rack, you know, some of these installs you may be tempted to coil it and then hide it above the tile, and that's, you know, somewhat frowned upon just because you have loose cable up there. If you have an electrician, somebody else working at the location, they may think, what's this cable? I guess it's just hanging out up here. We can go ahead and cut it since probably nobody's using it. So what you might want to consider is making a nice little loop. Just dress it up. For example, this one here. It looks like an indoor armored tight buffered fiber. And it looks like they have cable ties that are just mounted to the wall to keep in place nice and neat. So that might be something else you might want to think about. Thanks for watching, and hopefully you got some great tips on what to do with that extra cable. And questions, comment below, and I'll be happy to answer. Thanks. Bye-bye.